assure you.
Yes, I quite agree with you, Mother. That type should be kept in its place. Don't you think so, Dale?
That depends on the type and the place.
A different color every year, but they still call her red.
Pan the chatter, save your pet for Panama.
Say, you'd forget your rosy cheeks if they weren't slapped down with a paintbrush.
I know I had them when I bumped into that traveling man last night.
The breaks I get. Another farmer's daughter. Have you looked in the First National?
Oh.
Hurried.
Well, try the second branch, you sim.
Oh. Hot-cha! Hot dog!
One side, sailor. You ain't seen nothing yet.
In all the world, no trip like this.
Hi, skipper. How's your old compass?
Well, hello, Miss Snell. Glad to see you again.
Hey, Admiral, are there any hoppy hoppers on this tug?
Scram, dumbbell. Cramp yourself till you get where you can use it. Hey, down!
Hey, sailor! Look who's back!
Come on, me. Saloon, Skip. If you'll excuse me, Mr. Grayson, I think I'll go down to my cabin.
Well, I'll see you later, won't I?
Why, yes. Unless you look the other way.
That's it.
I think it is. Who's the roommate?
Last time you bumped me with a contortionist. Every time I looked at her in bed, I thought I was having a nightmare.
Oh, she's a kid I picked up in Frisco. Kind of green, but she can sing.
Oh, amateur, huh? What are we supposed to do, wiener?
Well, there's nothing like a little fresh meat. After all, customers get kind of tired of has-beens.
You should know.
Why, you low-down plug face. Oh, as I was saying, dear, we're going to have a delightful trip.
Why, here's Miss Jordan now.
Jolly what? Oh, hello, Miss Jordan. Received my wire, eh? Yes, I did, Miss Snell. I didn't really expect to hear from you. This is Jerry Royal, your roommate. Been with me before, and she knows the ropes. How do you do, Miss Royal?
Shake, Jordan. Hey, Trixie, when do rehearsal start?
Not till this gang of slobs get their sea legs. And listen, you, keep your mitts off those sailors. They've got enough on their hands keeping this tub afloat.
The last we'll see of Trixie till we get into port. She's a good egg, except when she gets scrambled. Got a nail file, honey?
What's the matter? Did you lose the key?
No, I locked it in my trunk so they'll know where it is. It's your first time in show business?
Yes, it's my first offense.
Well, you sure picked a tough spot for a beginner.
Well, you've got to begin someplace.
Yeah? Well, you don't know the bull ring or Trixie Snell's technique.
Have you been there before?
Honey, I've been to Panama so often, I feel like an isthmus.
Oh, well, if it's so bad, why do you and the other girls keep on going back again?
Oh, different girls, different reasons. But mostly because it's just our speed. You know, you can't make a silk purse out of a horse's neck. And there's another reason. Good hunting for husbands. Say, there's 20 unmarried men to every woman. Why, it's a regular he harem.
I shouldn't think a good-looking girl like you'd have any trouble finding a husband. She wanted one.
Thanks for them kind words, sister, but I am married.
You are?
Yeah, are, am, was, and is going to be.
Oh, you're joking.
No, sir. Three times loser. Trouble with me is I go gaga over tattoo marks. Three splices and three sailors. The kind of sailors I hitched up with ain't never seen an anchor.
How do you lose them? They don't just run away, do they?
Well, some of them get lost in the fog. The rest of them I just throw out.
Well, it was open all the time.
They forgot to lock it. Well, that was number one. Olaf Anderson. He was a pretty good guy. Not much to look at. But, oh, sister, what a man.
What happened to him?
Poor Olaf. He signed on one of those round-the-world cruises, lost his boat in Shanghai, and I guess that dumb dodo can't learn enough Chinese to ask his way home.
Want me to help you put your things away?
Nope, I don't need any help. Well, I'm all settled. Heaven help the poor sailors on a night like this.
I thought you said you'd sworn off on sailors.
Well, a gal's got to have some practice. Some of those sailors are pretty good at practice.
So your girlfriend turned out to be one of Trixie Snell's hot numbers. Frightful headache. Will you see me to my cabin? Coming, children.
Miss Jordan, I've been waiting for days to find someone to introduce us. It looks as though I'll have to take fate by the forelock and present myself.
How do you do, Mr. Bayless?
You knew my name.
You knew mine.
Would you dance?
Aren't you afraid you'll lose your social standing?
I haven't any. I might acquire some dancing with you.
Phew! How many ports have you been in?
A whole lot, baby, but I always go back to the same one.
The same what?
Back home where there's Mama and Gretchen and Mabel and Catherine and Isaacs and Aloysius and a baby I ain't even seen yet.
And what am I supposed to be, the godmother?
Do you realize that for the whole evening you've made me talk of nothing but myself?
I certainly couldn't think of a better subject.
Mr. Bayless, suppose you tell me the story of your life.
You think you'd be interested?
That depends on the story.
It's a long one. Probably take all of tomorrow afternoon. Think you could stand it?
I think so, Mr. Bailey.
Tom.
Tom. Oh, it must be very late. I think I'd better go. I've had a delightful evening, Tom.
Good night, Dale.
Good night, Tom.
$10 gold piece. Allow me to help you, my dear.
Deuced embarrassing, what?
Here, here.
I think the bally thing rolled under my chair.
Here.
Well, still dropping things, I see.
Oh.
kid. I guess you've been having quite a laugh at my expense, haven't you?
Laugh? What do you mean by coming into my room?
Oh, well, the joke's on me, all right. Here I was being so very, very careful. And all the time you were one of Trixie Snell's girls.
I think you've made a mistake. Good night, Mr. Grayson.
Oh, come on, kid. That act's over. Be yourself.
Is your face red?
Oh, I see. Just a couple of...
Outside, Bluebeard. Scram, Bug, before I step on you. Say, you're no babe in rompers. You can take care of yourself. Only your technique's old-fashioned.
Old-fashioned?
Yeah, that face-slapping gag. It's amateurish. It's all right for them parlor books and all that. But say, when a goof makes a pass at me, I ups to him and gives him a right hook to the kisser. You know, you gotta be prepared for things like that when you get in a troupe of Trixies.
Maybe I should have studied boxing instead of singing.
You think you're kidding? Maybe you'll wish you had. You're gonna meet plenty of palookas.
Sure, you make it sound pretty terrible.
Oh, gee, kid. I didn't mean to scare you. You just tie onto Jerry's apron strings and everything will be all right. You know, Jerry knows they're onions. And they're tamales, too.
Why, Tom, what an odd curio.
Sort of good luck charm. I got it from an Indian chap that I managed to pull out of the water down in the San Blas Islands.
That's where your business is?
I'm in the copper trade down there. It's pretty wild. Often I don't see a white man for months. Spend my days visiting native villages, sleeping outdoors.
Sounds almost as exciting as the bull ring.
Dale, tell me, how much do you actually know about Trixie Snell and the bull ring?
Not much, but I seem to be learning.
But you must have known something about what you were getting yourself in for.
Things are a little different from what I thought they'd be, but I think I'll be able to take care of myself all right.
Well, I hope so. You know, until I heard about your stage ambitions, I was a little puzzled at seeing a girl like you in Trixie's troupe. Most of the girls in the bullring I've known signed up with Trixie either as a last resort or at most because they were hunting for sensations.
I don't think I really belong to either class.
Hall. Say, what is this hall business you're always getting on?
Why, my dear, it's an expletive that is indigenous to my stratum.
You don't mean it. Isn't there something a doctor could do about it?
Oh.
We're right back where we started.
I say, you know, I was quite distressed over your losing your money last night. So after you'd retired, I went back to your chair and looked around for your gold piece.
Quite sporting of you, old thing. Too bad you didn't find it.
But I did, you know, right under your chair. You know, I have remarkable eyesight.
Remarkable eyesight? Why, you're a walking microscope. I think you're a honey.
I say, old thing, I think you're a little bit of all right yourself. Quite spiffing.
What? Say, what is this old thing and spiffing business? Are you trying to make fun of me?
My word, old dear.
So you're making fun of me, huh? Say, listen, Egg, if you think you can make fun of me for $10, you're screwy.
Paul.
Well, Tom, tomorrow we'll be in Panama.
That's right. This is our last night out.
I better hurry and dress. What's the matter, Tom? You look as glum as one of those Indians on that island of yours.
Oh, I don't know, Dale. Thought of your leaving is bad enough. Leaving with Trixie Snell and all that.
That's awfully sweet, Tom.
I'm really flattered that you should be worried about me.
Worried about you? Why, Dale, I...
All right, kid, come up for air.
Jerry! I didn't know you were here.
I'd like to know how you do it.
Do what?
Turn a sphinx into a caveman in 6 days. Wish you'd loan me some of your technique.
You seem to be doing all right with the men. How about your friend Uppy?
Oh, I ditched him 2 days ago.
What?
You know the ritzy way I talk when I try to impress someone?
Yes.
Well, Uppy tried the same thing on me, so I gave him the air.
But Jerry, that's the way Mr. Upson really talks.
Oh, my gosh. Well, why didn't he say so?
What a glorious night.
Everlasting moonlight. One of the baits of the tropics. Face the truth, Dale. Half the girls who come down here never get home unless some man pays their way.
You're exaggerating.
I'm not exaggerating. I know what I'm talking about. I've seen how it goes. The girls start drinking to forget how rotten and sordid the whole thing is. They show up some night too drunk to go on. There's a fight with Trixie and she kicks them out.
But Tom, nothing like that's going to happen to me.
It might, Dale. That's why I'm worrying. I'm crazy about you. I've even thought about selling my business interests.
Tom.
It might sound foolish, but... well, maybe if you'd promise not to drink. After all, that's how the whole thing starts.
You're cheapening me by even asking such a thing.
Cheapen you? Well, you've cheapened yourself already by associating with Trixie's crowd.
Tom!
Why act like a child? Why put yourself in the way of temptations that thousands of women haven't been able to resist?
Just a minute. I've had just about enough of this. It's going to take more than climate or a crowd to make me a wanton.
I know,
as
Dale,
but... Trixie's crowd, I only really know one of them. She's an example of the rest. I'll throw my lot in with them. Not a word. Maybe he's out in front.
Yeah, sipping a lemonade.
Hey, handsome. Who's the stew at the end table?
Wait.
All right, girls, let's go. Get into luck. See you later, kid. Good luck.
Thank you.
showed about as much pep as a nervous oyster. What's the matter? Too much navy on the boat?
Oh, I don't know. I guess it's the heat.
Well, you'll be in a hotter place someday. Jerry, not so bad, but next time give them all you got. No rainy days down here to save anything for. Jordan, you're on next. Come on. On the up and up, kid. You never played a cabaret before, did you?
No. Only college shows.
I knew you were lying. They all do. Well, you're on the spot now. Honey boy. There's the one I mean.
Oh, you mean the one with the glasses. Well, that might be the...
All right, sucker. Now there's two of you.
To a traveling salesman's prayer. She can go up and down the scale faster than a Wall Street bond. She's been a hit in New York and Chicago and other foreign countries. So get a firm grip on your blood pressure and meet Miss Dale Jordan.
Your hat, sir.
see that Miss Dale Jordan gets this, please?
Yes, sir.
All right, scallions, get out and make the customers thirsty.
Okay.
Well, Goofus, what do you want?
I got a...
Here, Jordan, you've collected a dividend already. All right, Nosey, take a run out, powder.
There's a guy at table, say 16, calling for Miss Royal.
Maybe I'll get a break, too. Hey, wait a minute. See that he buys plenty, and don't let that whiskey tenor of yours catch up on you.
Jerry Royal, you've hung that picture in a different spot every week for 3 months. Every time you hang it crooked.
That's the right stance for number one. Every time he came home, he gave a list to the starboard. Well, we're going to feed the flesh this morning or rehearse on an aspirin tablet?
I don't feel fit for anything.
Oh, snap out of it.
I don't know whether it's the heat or what it is that's getting me. I'm so tired of the same old faces and the same old songs.
Oh, it affects different people different ways. Now, take me, for instance. I like to get drunk and go on a toot and kick Trixie's cash register.
Sometimes I wonder whether Tom Baylor wasn't partly right.
Of course he was right, but don't give him a break and admit it. Well, it won't be long now, baby. Keep a stiff upper lip. That's all we got to do is keep our head in the clinches. Well, how'd you like your hen fruit?
Let's have them sunny side up.
Atta, girl. We'll have them.
Phil, that one's different. I'd like to meet her.
That should be easy. Say, Trixie.
I'm off you for life, Bill Burr. Me with a brand new show, and it's taken you 2-3 months to get around here.
Don't blame me, Trix. The boss has kept me jumping ever since he got in from Havana. Oh, Trix, meet Jim Crosby.
How do you do?
General Manager, Standard Airlines. And general nuisance round the Panama office.
Not Jimmy Crosby, the flyer.
Right.
Gosh, Jimmy, I saw you at the races last year, and you gave me heart pain.
He's been doing that to girls for years.
Say, Trick, how about the little girl that did the last number?
Lay off, kid. She'd give a cold potato chills.
Come on. I've baked some potatoes before.
Any of the others, Jimmy. But not this one. You'd only be wasting your time.
Well, it'd be the first time I ever have. I've got $100 that says I won't be wasting my time.
And I've got $100 that says you will.
It's a bet. bet.
Go buy yourself some lollipops.
I like all day suckers, too.
Good night, Mr. Crosby.
Say, how about a little supper with me somewhere after you're through here?
No, thank you, Mr. Crosby. Not tonight.
Well, Miss Jordan, how about breakfast at my hotel in the morning?
Yes.
You're very sweet, Dale.
You've been very sweet too, Jimmy.
You know, if I'd had my way, we'd be drinking champagne up in my room.
And I'd show up for rehearsal full of champagne, and Trixie'd kick me out.
Oh, come on, Dale. Couldn't you chuck rehearsal just for today?
No, I'm afraid not, Jimmy.
Well, how about tomorrow? I thought we might take a little spin in my car. Have a nice day.
Oh, lovely. It's been like a dream.
Feel like going back to the bullring?
Of course I don't, Jimmy. But I have to.
You don't have to go back there, Dale. I could make life very happy for you. Make this day last forever.
You don't believe that, Jimmy. Any more than I do. There'd have to be a rude awakening sometime.
I love you, Dale. I mean it. Oh, I admit I've said that many times before. I haven't been exactly a plaster saint. But you've made me realize for the first time what it means to say, I love you.
Jimmy, no wonder you swept them off their feet.
You know what I'd like to do? Hop into my plane with you and fly back to the States. It would only take a few hours.
Mr. Crosby, am I to consider this a proposal?
You can take this any way you want to. You name the terms.
But I don't love you.
I could make you love me.
Well, Jimmy, if you can make me love you, I'll marry you, of course. But if you don't take me right back to town, I'll be late for my number at the bull ring.
You mean he actually asked you to marry him?
Well, that was the general idea, darling. But I don't love him.
Oh, baloney. I married three clefs who couldn't give me anything but love. It's a high-class name for hooey. Say, you still stuck on that bimbo from the Indian country? What'd he ever give you? Worm-eating piece of coral neck to his wigwam. Say, the big salami did you a favor. If you let that Crosby off the hook, you ought to be.
Say, passion flower, what's the idea of keeping that Dutch skipper waiting?
Oh, nerd. He's so dumb we have to talk in the sign language. He can't even recognize a stop signal.
Your boyfriend's outside, innocent. And listen, if you bail out of Panama with Crosby, I want a month's notice to get another singer. You savvy?
I don't think you need to worry about it, Trixie.
Well, I don't care, but I never allow love to interfere with business.
I thought that in your case, they were the same thing.
Say, listen, High Hat. Did you ever get a sock in the beezer?
No. How does it feel? Off that kid.
You're on next, you know.
Hey, where is this Germany? In Switzerland?
Switzerland, nothing. It's just on the other side of Hoboken.
Oh, that's what. Ducky Wucky.
Well, what's the matter, Dale? You look worried.
Trixie's been hitting the bottle lately, and the girls are all on edge.
You know what I told you. Over and over again.
Yes, I know, Jimmy.
Oh, don't you, old man.
Why, you old
pretzel.
What? You want a pretzel? Better, better. What is los here?
No,
better.
Stupid, I got one. He wants a bottle of champagne.
Champagne.
And now, folks, I'm going to introduce the sweetest little girl, Miss DeLory. Jim Hammond. Sit tight, honey. I'll be right back.
Oh, Bidman.
You little pig, what do you mean by holding up my show?
I can't go on. I'm homesick.
You think this poison's going to cure you? I won't have you freaking before your numbers.
I'm fed up with you and your rotten old show.
Why, you dirty little ungrateful.
Excuse me, Jimmy, I might have to go on.
Stay here, you fool. I'll beat some brains into you, you cheap little. Keep out of my business or I'll give you a dose of this yourself.
I've never known a woman as low as you.
Raise that bottle 1 inch and I'll knock those false teeth of yours down your gizzard.
Jimmy, get me out of this. Take me away, anywhere.
Well, what's happened?
You don't have to go back there.
Jimmy, do you still mean what you said about marrying me?
Why, yes. Yes, of course.
All right. I'll fly to New York with you tomorrow. And I'll spend my whole life being grateful to you for taking me out of all this.
You got my note.
Oh, yes. Jerry, dear, won't you come and visit me in my suite at the Hotel Washington? Boy, what a dump this is. Never saw so much plush since Astor's pet horse died. Oh. Boy, if I ever climbed into this, I'd never get out. Putting you up in style, huh?
Oh, no, Jerry. I'm paying for this. That's the way it's going to be until after we're married.
Well, you better get hitched in a hurry. Your bankroll won't stand this over a couple of days. When are the festivities coming off?
We'll probably start to fly to New York late today or early tomorrow.
When's the splicing going to be? Before or after? I mean, before or after New York?
Oh, I'm willing to leave that to Jimmy. The only thing I'm sorry about is leaving you, Jerry.
And I miss you too, kid. And I'm glad for your sake. You never were cut out for this kind of a racket. It's only for slobs like me.
Oh, no, it isn't, honey. You've got to get out of it, too.
Sure. When one of my ships comes in.
Come in. Oh, good morning, Jimmy.
Hello, darling.
You remember Jerry, don't you?
Well, yes, of course. How are you, Jerry?
Oh, topping. Well, I guess I better be going. I'll see you before you go, won't I?
Well, of course.
Jerry, I'm going out and buy some clothes. Why don't you drop in this afternoon and look them over?
Okay, I'll do that. So long, Crosby. You're a lucky egg.
How are you, darling?
I'm fine, thanks, Jimmy. When do you think we'll be getting away?
Well, I don't know just yet. I have some business affairs to attend to. And then I've got to test out that plane. Tell you what I'll do. I'll fly over the hotel. It'll be about 4 o'clock.
I'll be watching for you. Why don't you sit down?
Well, if you don't mind, dear, I've got to get back to the office. I'm expecting an important message. There's nothing else you need, is there?
No.
Money?
No, thanks, Jimmy. I don't want to take it. Not yet, anyway.
Sold out. Going back to San Francisco.
Well, I guess this place will struggle along without you. You never gave me much of a play anyway.
Listen, Trixie, can you give me Miss Jordan's address?
Sure, that's easy to remember. Washington Hotel. Just ask for Jimmy Crosby's suite.
What?
Sure, she's been playing around with him for a week. She's a smart girl. She'll do all right for Dale Jordan. But she ran out on me and left me in the lurch. And if I never see that snob again, it'll be years too soon.
Hello, Miss Baylor.
Want your key?
Do you have a Miss Dale Jordan registered here?
Yes. She's out now. Want to leave a message?
I don't think so.
She's checking out tonight or tomorrow morning, flying to New York with Jimmy Crosby.
When my luggage arrives, check it through to San Francisco. You have my forwarding address.
Yes, sir.
Why, Tom.
Hello, Dale.
I've been buying some new clothes.
So I see. Doing all right, aren't you? I guess I was wrong about you. You're really doing better than I expected.
What do you mean?
Well, you moved up from the Bull Ring to the Washington Hotel. I understand the next hop is New York. And I suppose a Park Avenue apartment.
Yes, Mr. Baylor. I'm afraid that if I stayed in this part of the world any longer, I might be contaminated by some of its filth. My key, please. Thank you.
Going out of the lobby.
I know. I saw him, too.
You did? And?
I don't know, Jerry. Maybe it'll do me good to get away. I guess Tom Baylor's just one of those things that's in the air down here.
Well, he won't be here much longer. He's checking out bag and baggage. What is this? A new trousseau? Boy, it must have cost plenty of sugar.
Everything I had but a couple of dollars.
Hey, what is this? A marriage or a Dutch treat?
I've been looking all over for you. What's up?
Bill, I got myself into a tough spot. You know about me and Dale.
You never told me you were married, Jim.
It was years ago, Bill. Before I ever even knew you. It's just one of those things. A woman's impossible. Every son I've ever given has been just like blackmail.
What are you going to do about Dale?
I don't know. That's what I've got to think out. My plane ready?
It's ready now. You're in no condition to fly, old man.
Don't you worry about me, Bill. That's where I've always thought things out. Solved all of my problems. Up in the clouds.
Boy, I could get myself an admiral in this, huh?
That must be Jimmy now.
Isn't it thrilling?
You can have it.
Well, I've got to go get packed now.
Oh, I'll pick them up and tie them in a bundle and throw them in like I do.
$2.75. What should we blow it in on?
How about a bottle of scotch? Now, I'm liable to get sentimental and turn on the waterworks all over your new dress.
I have an idea. Let's get some flowers to brighten up the room for Jimmy when he comes back.
Okay, kid. Anything but heliotrope. Gives me hay fever.
Hello? Yes? Mr. Barrett? Certainly, send him right up. Oh, wait a minute. Will you please ask the florist to send me up some flowers? Oh, about $2.75 worth. Thank you. Bill Barrett's on his way up. I wonder what he wants.
Probably trailing me to find out why I didn't buy those lollipops.
Come in. Hello, Mr. Barrett. How are you?
How'd you do, old thing? It's a topping day. What?
Why, Mr. Barrett, is there anything wrong?
Jimmy. Crashed.
Kid. He was a regular guy.
You'll never know quite how regular he was.
Here are your flowers, Miss Jordan.
You got your nerve coming back asking for a job? Threw me down for a mug that was on the make for you.
Please don't talk like that about Jimmy Crosby.
Sure, he was gonna marry Dale. Well, you poor sap. He bet me $100 on you. Looks like if he hadn't cashed in, I'd have to pay the bet. Now listen, Trixie. You lay off of Dale. She's been through enough. Say you get fresh with me and you'll go out on your ear, too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you sailor's delight. I know how you feel about this Cobra joint, Dale. Gosh, we gotta eat, let alone earn enough dough to get out of this godforsaken old woman's land.
I know, Jerry, but that man Berger that runs the place. Revolting. Aren't there any more cabarets we haven't tried?
Listen, I've tramped the streets until my pet Bunyan's gone on strike. Trixie and the Bullring have all the high-class trade in town all sewed up.
the rest of the joints are just like the Cobra.
You're too good for him, huh?
Why, no, Mr. Berger. I thought it was time for my song. $139, $140, $141.
Uh-uh.
Oh, and, 85 cents. Only $65 to go, and we're on our way to San Francisco.
Only 10 more days in that burger joint. Oh, stomach, be good to me now.
Oh, Jerry, why don't you keep your own money? I don't like the responsibility for all of us.
Oh, you don't know me like I do. A dreadnought's liable to come into port. I'll wake up to find I've been out in a binge and bought the grog for the whole fleet.
Come on, baby. Give us a sweet little kiss, huh? Give us a kiss, huh?
You blame at my customers and friends or get out.
I'm here to sing. Not to be mauled by a lot of drunken sots.
Is that so? Well, I don't want no lilies around here. You're through. Get out!
Hello, Berger.
Hello.
Indian Joe around?
Well, why do you want Joe?
Plenty. Another knife in the dock. Come on, Joe. The captain wants to talk to you.
Thank you.
you can come in for a minute, Miss Jordan, but please don't excite the patient. She's a little weak.
Gary, honey.
How are you, Dale? Number one could only see me now.
You're feeling better, aren't you?
Sure, I'll be okay. It's a knife more or less in your gizzard. Listen, kid, I want you to promise me something.
Of course, Jerry. Anything.
Don't you give old Sawbones or this joint any of the dough we saved up. I want you to buy yourself a ticket and scram for Frisco.
Oh, no, Jerry. I couldn't do that.
Do what I tell you. Don't be a sap. This joint can't throw me out. Let them stand the gaff.
I'll come to see you every day, honey. All you have to worry about is getting well.
Don't forget what I told you.
Still pretty weak, isn't she?
Yes. I am afraid it's going to be a long convalescence. She lost a great deal of blood, you know.
What do you think we ought to do for her?
What she needs most is sunlight, proper nourishment, and treatment. The place for her is a sanitarium.
How much will that cost?
We have one near here, where the rates are rather reasonable. Somewhere around $50 a week.
All right, doctor. You make the arrangements.
The hospital bills are payable in advance. The total is $174.
Here's $150. I'll get the rest. Somehow. Come in. Tom!
Why, Dale. I thought you were ill.